Welcome back to Geometry Classroom. Today we'll talk about properties of rectangles. In this lesson, we'll define and identify rectangles. Then we'll try to find missing sides and or missing angles of a rectangle and find the length of a diagonal of a rectangle. Now, what is a rectangle? A rectangle is a shape with four sides and four angles. Because of that, a rectangle is a quadrilateral, right? Belongs to the great family of quadrilaterals. But in the same time, a rectangle is a parallelogram. Why? Because a rectangle has all properties of a parallelogram. But a rectangle is a special case of parallelogram. Probably a rectangle is the most common shape we see in real life, in nature, right? For example, a computer screen is in the form of a rectangle, a book, a dollar bill, or a mouse pad, or a wall, or a building, right, is in the shape of a rectangle. So rectangles are very important. Then that's why we have to know more details about properties of rectangles. Good. Let's talk about properties of rectangles in more detail. Because a rectangle is a parallelogram, has all properties of a parallelogram. And which means they have some properties in common. The first property is opposite sides are parallel, right? For example, AD and BC are opposite, right? Because of that, they are parallel. Also, AB parallel DC because they are opposite. More than that, opposite sides are congruent, right? Which means AD congruent BC, AB congruent DC. Also, opposite angles are congruent, right? Opposite angles are angles that are across each other or face to face. For example, angle A and C are opposite and they are congruent. Angles D and B are also opposite and they are congruent. Also, consecutive angles are supplementary. How we identify consecutive angles? If we go clockwise, D and A are consecutive. Why? Because they follow each other. A and B are also consecutive, B and C, right? But not A and B, right? Because they don't follow each other. If you go counterclockwise, D is and A are consecutive, D and C, B and C, B and A, right? So they are supplementary, right? Consecutive angles, which means they add up 180. Now, but these properties are the only one that are common to both parallelograms and rectangles. Now, rectangles have two more specific properties, and these properties are all angles are right angles. As we can see, all angles are right angles, which means they have a measure of 90. Also, diagonals are congruent. Diagonals, right, are congruent. In a parallelogram, diagonals are not congruent. They just bisect each other, but they are not congruent. But for a rectangle, they are congruent. Now, using these properties, let's have a few examples of problems with rectangles. For example, in this example, it says find the value of x and the measure of angle DEG. Now, as we know, this angle has a measure of 90. But in the same time, this angle consists of these two other angles. Because these two angles add up 90, right? They are complementary, right? So, first, we find the value of x by writing the equation in terms of x, and then you will plug in the measure of angle DEG. First, let's write the equation. We're going to have 9x minus 6, right, plus 2x plus 8 equals 90, right? Because they add up 90. Now we combine x terms, 9x plus 2x equals 11x, and then negative 6 plus 8 would be 2 plus 2 equals 90. Then we get rid of 2 by subtracting 2 on both sides. Then we bring down 11x, we cancel 2 and negative 2, and on the right side we're going to have 88. Then to solve for x, we divide by 11 both sides, and we get x equals 8. Now, to find the measure of angle DEG, we plug in here, right? So we replace x with the value of x, of 8. 9 times 8 minus 6. 9 times 8 equals 72 minus 6 would be 66 degrees.
Good.
Another example is find the length of the given rectangle. So we have ZW, which is 2x plus 3, right? Let's write it here. And WX equals x plus 4. So we know the opposite sides of a rectangle are congruent, which means equal, right? Which is 2x plus 3 equals x plus 4. Good. Then we solve for x. First, we combine x terms by subtracting x on both sides. Why? Because the coefficient of this term is 2 and is larger than the coefficient of the other x terms, right? We combine everything on the left side. Now, 2x minus x would be x. We bring down plus 3 equals. We cancel x and negative x, and we bring down 4. Then we subtract 3 on both sides, and we'll get x equals, because these two cancel out, 1. Good. But it says find the length of the given rectangle. And the length is z, y, or wx, because they are equal. So let's plug it in here, right? So x we know is 1. So 2 times 1 plus 3. 2 times 1, if we apply PEMDAS, we'll have 2 plus 3, which is 5. That's the length of ZY. Good. Another type of problem involves diagonals. It says here, find the value of x. Now, we know diagonals in a rectangle are, they bisect each other, yes, and they are equal. Now, because they bisect each other and are congruent or equal, the resulting halves would be equal, right? Which means 9x plus 20 equals 10x plus 8. Now, to find x, we combine x terms on the right side this time. Why? Because the coefficient of this x term is larger than the coefficient of the other x term. So we subtract 9x on both sides, and we get 9x and negative 9x cancel. We bring down 20 equals 10x minus 9x is simply x, and we bring down 8. Then we subtract 8 on both sides. Now, 20 minus 8 equals 12 equals x. And we found the value of x. So that's all we have for today. Next time, we'll learn about properties of squares. By then, thank you for watching my video.